Assalamu alaikum sir. Topic for our presentation is about digital stopwatch. For presentation, I am going to introduce myself and my team members. I am Chaudhuri Nehru Nigar. My team members are Salahuddin Ilyas Khan, MD Mahfuzur Akhtar Rinku, and Khan MD Zubain. The contents of this presentation are introduction, components, and simulation. Introduction. A digital stopwatch can be a circuit displaying the actual time in minutes and seconds, or a circuit displaying the number of clock pulses. This should be done only using non-programmable components. The stopwatch also should count accurately. There should be a start-stop facility. After making the stopwatch and testing it, our project successfully matched over its specifications. The stopwatch counts accurately to the nearest second. The display also works fine, showing all the number accurately. This also shows that our counter and decoder works. Although we had a few minor, but our digital stopwatch was a success. The components we used for this presentation are 1. Interactive SPST switch, 1. Digital clock generator, 4. Dual decode ripple counter, 4. BCD to 7 segment decoder, 4. 7 segment common cathode. Now this presentation will continue Khan MD Zubain. Thank you.
My teammate Nehreen describe about the number 1 to 5 number slides. Now we can describe about 6 to 8 number slides. In this 6 number slide, we can see the interactive single pull single throw switch. We use this switch to start and reset the stopwatch. In this figure, we can see the interactive single pull single throw switch. In the next slide, we can see the digital clock generator. We used the following setting for our clock generator. The clock type is low, high, low clock, having a period of 100 ms. And in the last number of slide, we can see the description about the dual decode ripple counter, model device model 74LS390. The 74LS390 IC contains a pair of high speed 4 stage ripple counters. Each half of the LS390 is partitioned into a device by 2 section and a divide by 5 section with a separate clock input for each section. The 2 sections can be connected to count in a 8421 BCD code, or theory can count in a binary query sequence to provide a square wave 50% duty cycle at the final output. Each hub of the LS393 operates as a modulo 16 binary divider. With the last 3 stages, we can see that triggered in a ripple fashion. The flip-flops are triggered by a high to low transaction of the CP inputs. It goes through the 10 unique combinations of outputs and resets for every new clock input. It's all about my presentation, sir. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Now I'm going to discuss about the next chip we used. It is a BCD to 7 segment decoder, 4511. The 4511 accepts a binary input and converts this into a corresponding output to drive a 7 segment display. The decoder only accepts binary coded decimal and the binary numbers 0 to 9. All binary inputs are ignored. All other binary inputs are ignored. The 4511 can also store the input. The 4511 decoder is designed to work with the 4510 BCD counter and will source enough current to drive a standard common cathode 7 segment display with an appropriate current limiting resistor. For our experiment, we use the 7 segment common cathode. In a 7 segment common cathode, all the cathode connections of the LED segments are connected together to logic 0 or ground. The separate segments are lighted by applying the logic 1 or high signal through a current limiting resistor to forward bias the individual anode terminal A to G. This is the circuit diagram. Now I'm going to show you the simulation. Assalamualaikum. My name is Salahuddin Ilyas Khan. I am going to show the simulation of our project stopwatch. At first, we selected a clock generator. The clock type is low high low clock and the time period is 100 milliseconds. Here we have taken a basic SPST switch in order to control the circuit. This is a 74LS39, which is a dual decade ripple counter. We used a BCD to 7 segment decoder and a cathode 7 segment display here in this project. We have connected them in the necessary way to start our project. Here we'll now run the simulation. As you can see, it has started counting, and every time it reaches 9 and resets to 0, 1 is added here. In this way, our circuit works. This is the circuit simulation circuit diagram. Thank you.